Yes, Darren, it was picker team number two from the forum. Hey everybody, it's Kisby here from CardCollective.net. We are about to break 2017 eBay break number 8, Donruss half case. This was the other half case from the other night, a Thursday night. We'll go to the U.S. side of the frame when we come back. We're backed up by an hour. For some, I think the time change messed up on the ending times on the eBay because everything was a half hour, hour off on the ending time. So, like, we were supposed to break the basketball at 7, but it didn't, the last team didn't end the auction until 7:30. So, I think it messed up our software that we were using to upload. That or the girl uploading the video screwed up, but I don't think she did. She's pretty smart. Yeah, football's next. Hello, Squirrel. Squirrel, you just have the two teams, right? On the Heritage.
A three-run number one and a four-run number two, including a Nolan Arenado home run. Otherwise, just a Buster Posey solo shot. And here we are, 10 hits leading to 8 runs for the U.S. The story, in addition to that offensive explosion in the beginning of the game, has been the pitching carrying them the whole way, something that could be a strength for this team moving forward.
Yeah, I'll run a filler for that. So, yeah, buy up the spots. Alright, yours will be out in the morning then. That way I don't have to, you know, I didn't know if you had any eBay stuff.
Yelich coming up. So a couple things could happen here, Cliff.
Acquiesce test immediately. Meadows Pirates.
Christian Yelich up right now against Dustin.
That's Joel,
32-year-old.
I might do this a little different tonight.
That would be the early termination rule, 10 runs or more.
Chris Bryant, pink. Rhino pink. Name variant. Hey, we haven't had a Glenn Otto yet. Out of 149, who got this? Joel.
We saw a real walk-off by the U.S. Adam Jones in game one. Much more offense tonight, including Yelich with 2 base hits in his first 2 trips to the plate.
Christian Yelich, just mentioned.
Alex Bregman, the youngster in this group. On deck, I like him. 22-year-old with the Houston Astros.
Another Nelson Cruz. We had the out of five pulled earlier in a also store break.
Somewhat of a utility guy for this team. Astros have been putting him all over the baseball fields. Pitch skips away. Jones trots to third. We also could see the strikeout record.
Joel again. 3 for 3. By the way, guys, this is the last big break. We've only sorted two of the Donruss so far. Toronto Hap out of 49. So this break will be the last to probably be sorted.
That was crazy.
Chris.
This looks like it'll be playable in foul ground.
Out of 25. Nice.
Over his shoulder, and Jones stays put. Underrated part of the last game, two starters for a thin Columbia team that needs all nine. Bounced from the contest for making contact with the umpire, and it was not very physical, but Tito Polo and Reynaldo Rodriguez.
Hey, Nats fan. Ever
any
still
experiences
in the room?
Like that?
Yeah. I mean, I've gotten to a couple altercations, you know, shouting matches. Absolutely. When umpires would never bump him.
Berrios on a 99.
Automatic ejection.
Now Alex Bregman from Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Smart.
USA Today Minor League Player of the Year back in 2016. His rookie year with the Houston Astros, 2010 USA Baseball Player of the Year.
Verlander out of 999.
He needs a room full of awards, and he's 22 years old.
Frank Thomas, Black MVP variant. Wojo. Rod Crew, Masters of the Game out of 999 for the Twins.
Now's the time. MLB debut on July 25th. You know, he was hitless in his first 18 big league at-bats. I remember watching the game.
Kluber out of 227 for the Indians.
First big league hit, keep the baseball and all that, and maybe goes 2,999 to go. He told him that.
Steven.
Pretty cool to have Miggy at first.
Oh, yeah.
When you pull that off. We're going to see Miggy in San Diego for Team Venezuela. Yeah, after those first 10 games, the Astros saw what they were working with. He was over
Jay Bruce. Met Jay Bruce.
His manager, AJ
Jerry.
Hitch, as he's down on strikes, calls him into his office and says he had been playing in the 6 or the 7 hole. He says, "You're going to the 2 spot." He's like, "Really?" They said,
"Well, you don't play a lot. See that bat lag through the zone a little bit. He'll catch up soon."
Arenado out of 500.
He actually was, you know, he was recruited by Team Israel. So
the Express
there,
variant.
Would have been playing.
We would play every day.
Yes.
Right?
That was the difference. Good point.
Yeah.
Now Eric Hosmer swinging on the first pitch, lifting it to
So this definitely won't be shipped until next weekend at the earliest.
Renee Tassoni, what's he doing? Who knows?
Beltran, hey, Texas.
Long throw.
Unless, you know, unless it gets, can get sorted quicker.
Showing off his arm for scouts.
And the shipping is knocked out fast, but man. So much base to ship. Thanks, KC. So bad, why? You mean the card's being pulled? Oh man, I hope my wife included that into your box when she packed it up. The problem with it is it's glass and it's real hard to package. And I'm not sure, it's hard with the pictures, the big oversized pictures. I don't know what she, hopefully she did. I told her it needed to go with your box. Mm. How many spots is left in the plates and patches?
One pitch, one swing, one out. Nate Jones retires Josh Naylor. A 19-year-old prospect, along with Tyler O'Neill, these are the top prospects on Team Canada, according to MLBPipeline.com. O'Neill, number 36 overall in baseball, and number 89, Josh Naylor, both of them with some major power, and both played in the 2016 Futures game. O'Neill up next.
What you hope for is experience in the next 4 years.
Naquin on a 999.
Hopefully gets up and play for Team Canada again in the WBC. Could bring Freddie Freeman or someone else.
Man, there's some Russell. We pull a million of these.
Because these two right here that we just showed on the screen is going to be really good.
Yeah, Naylor actually was the highest drafted Canadian-born hitter ever. Four spots higher than Brett Laurie, who had the previous mark in 2008.
Frank Thomas at a 199.
To the Miami Marlins, now in the Padres chain because of the Andrew Cashner trade back in July. I feel like everybody involved in that Andrew Cashner trade besides him in this cool sequel.
Trout slide. Variant.
21 years old.
$9.99. George Brett.
There's Josh Naylor. And Morneau right in front of him. Those two have been spending a lot of time together. Ernie Witt told us the first day we talked to him. I love those two hanging out because Witt wants to keep managing this team going forward, and he wants the veterans to pay it forward and show the youngins how it's done. O'Neill down on strikes, 98 from Nate Jones.
And that's the only way to handle, you know, the failure part of this game is hang around guys like Justin Morneau, who can talk you through, you know, tough times. I mean, I know he's at the sort of the end of his career. I'm not going to take the jersey off his back, but so proud Canadian has played in all, you know, four WBC.
Verlander to 349 for the Tigres.
He enjoys every bit of representing his country.
Tom and Chivon, help us out. Maybe on Twitter or something, Canadian fans. That's got Ron, will you?
At Cliff Floyd 30. But I hate giving it out.
Why?
I don't know. But I hate...
They can find it in 5 seconds.
I don't go on there enough. That's why.
I'll check it for you.
Because people write and go, why do you have Twitter if you don't respond to messages?
I'll be
I think
Twitter.
It's a good point.
Two out of Morneau.
Russell.
Roll to short, Brandon Crawford. USA defense is
Jack really Peterson out of 443. America! America. chicken, man.
Well, I'll tell you what, I had a blast. This has been unbelievable. A couple doubleheaders. Team USA moving on. Two powerhouses down here. Team DR going on to San Diego. A great baseball. We see some youth, some youngsters of the future. Team Columbia plays really good baseball. Had a really good tournament. Team Canada didn't hit enough, but...
Franco out of 148.
I saw a couple of guys.
What up, Rob?
We'll probably see the next WBC at some point. And, well, it's all down here, man. I couldn't ask for a better.
Phyllis.
Six games.
The DR went undefeated. Handshakes.
Chris Bryant, Pinky.
Between the Canadians and the U.S. A United States team that goes 2-1, and oh, man, they were close. 5-0 over the DR, but I think 6, 7, and 8 threw 7 runs.
Out of 10, Jim Palmer, artist proof.
This will be a rematch in California. Round number 2. Israel and Japan already off to 1-0 starts in Tokyo. The Netherlands losing to Japan earlier. I think it was this morning, I guess you could say. And Cuba.
Ryan. On a 99. The Express variant.
How are you going to pick from this?
There's the cheese.
Puerto Rico, United States, and then still 3 in the mix. But if Venezuela wins tonight.
This is a Mookie Betts photo variant.
It would be all chalk on that side of the bracket.
Don't see it as often as the other one.
The Dominican Republic, Tuesday, 9 p.m. Eastern. Wow. You want to see talent. When you see teams like this with many all-stars, the USA, the Dominicans, the Puerto Ricans, and Venezuela.
Anthony Elford. See a lot of these autos.
With national pride on the line.
Not numbered to 99 necessarily, because there's only 90.
It creates a playoff vibe.
Yeah, put your butt in the seat with some popcorn and drink and you sit there and watch some good baseball. In March, I think that's key. I mean, but for down here, great week in Miami. I mean, electric atmosphere. The fans came out in full effect. Packed the house. The cultures from all over. Every country represented. And I'm glad I was a part of it. It's got to be. I don't know about you.
Me too. This went quick. The games were entertaining. Manny Machado named the MVP of Pool C. Those Colombians making a name for themselves with the win over
Whit Merrifield. Merrifield. What up, Dean?
They threatened the U.S., losing by a run. They also went to extras against the Dominican Republic. Oh, and the Platino power. Too strong for Team USA, ultimately. In a Saturday night showdown for the ages. Cruz and Marte. Oh, you'll see them in San Diego. Same with USA and Rochella's group. They'll be back for the next run. But we'll move on to round 2. Machado and company. With a division that is going to be... so entertaining to watch. Cliff Floyd and the entire crew, so proud to bring you this World Baseball Classic coverage. I'm Scott Braun saying good night. Let's close the lights in Miami. Good night, world.
Oh, Donruss is gonna kill me. Cespedes out of 349 for the Medis.
Got a two-strike hitter and a two-strike approach, even when the count is not at two strikes. Brado getting the start at third base. He has struck out only once. He has drawn one walk. Mendoza's delivery to him and a big cut fouled off.
San Francisco.
The numbers you're looking at, Venezuela coming in. They're hitting 299. But opponents have hit 310 against them. The Venezuelan team has been outscored 21-11 in the first two games.
Scherzer, Dominator out of 99 for the Nationals.
7-2 for the Venezuelan staff. Mexico, they're coming in, having been outscored 19-13. Their ERA, 7.41. Swing and a miss on a pitch away, and Prado goes down. First strikeout for Mendoza. Here's the rest of the lineup for Venezuela.
After Fergie Prado, Jenkins, Texas.
Cabrera, then Gonzalez, Victor Martinez, Rodrigo Herrera, Alcides Escobar, and Arenciarte, and Robinson Chirinos, who is going to be doing the catching. We told you about the 5-for-5 picked up by Prado in the last game. You know, we saw a little bit of rain in between games 1 and 2, and I think right now that moisture just still exists in the air here has been quite productive. Favorable to the pitchers, both in keeping the ball in the ballpark and the grips.
Murph, black and white.
The spin of the baseball. Pitch will be taken by Cabrera. Cabrera is 2-for-7 as the Triple Crown winner stands in against Luis Mendoza. Mendoza's 33 years old. Pitched in the major leagues previously. He too with that long set. And again, he will come inside.
Margot on a 25, the rookies for the Padres. That's nice.
They were looking for in the last ball game. Cabrera with a 2-0 count. Mendoza pitched in Japan last year, 7-8, 3.88 earned run average. His delivery on the way, Cabrera got one to drive. That's going to go to center, but not deep. And it'll be handled by Verdugo easily. So both pitchers start.
Dave Winfield, press proof for the Padres on a 99.
We'll remind you throughout. Any hope Mexico has of moving on, they have got to win this game.
Who am I looking at right now? What I mean, listening to right now. Mexico and Venezuela. Miggy. Speaking of Venezuela. Venezuela. Dozier out of 346. Wins. David Price for the Red Sox out of 228. Ryan. George Brett out of 1 of 10 was pretty nice. Carson Fulmer. There you go, Wojo. Tom Seaver for the Mets at a 199. Greg Bird for the Yankees. Curtis? For Houston, out of 199, Joseph Musgrove.
For Mexico, our umpiring crew for the major leagues. Quinn Wolcott has the plate. Doug Eddings is at first. Michael Ulla is at second base. And Santos Castillo, out of the Dominican Republic, is at third. And the delivery, a check swing. And he looked down to first base, did not go around. Layer 2 for 9 and an RBI for Mexico so far in this pool play.
Pink bag holiday.
Petit the veteran. Try to keep you off balance as you'll speed up, slow down coming out of that stretch.
It's
one of the things that's happened in the past few years.
Rookie of the year, Seager.
Even starters now, when you're working out of this stretch, if there's nobody on base, you can't balk. So sometimes they'll come to the stretch and go right straight through without stopping. That's quick pitch. Yeah, quick pitch. Keep the timing off. Strike on the outside corner, and then they'll go back to actually holding it like you would if there was a runner on base. So hitters have to be really alert and alive for that, or they get surprised. To see if either of these two pitchers work sort of a set to do that. Laird will take the pitch outside. A little slider movement on that one, and a 3-ball, 1-strike count. If you think about it, Yu Darvish does it constantly.
They were pretty brutal on the damn corners, man. It probably could be graded. It wouldn't be that bad.
Why not get that mentality, that mode, right away? Correct? Makes sense. Of course.
Yeah.
So I don't think that's taught enough, or at least put into the minds of certain guys at an early age at any level. And especially in the minor leagues. The most important pitches you'll ever make under duress are from the stretch. Why not practice that in a game when there's nobody out? Learn more about delivery, waiting to do deception, and of course, sacrifice velocity.
Brandon Laird waiting on it. Check swing. Did he go? Ooh, he will go down to first base as a result. So Laird will pick up the walk and becomes the first base runner of the ball game.
It's been a good day for fly balls, and because of that moisture I'm talking about, this could be easily with 3 runs on the board. There's one that stays in the ballpark. 2 days ago, that's way gone. How about talk about Aegon? He thought he had it. Stays in the ballpark. Megan Cabrera hits the ball, and with the outfielders coming in, that tells you that that air right now is a little bit thicker.
Only one home run's been hit by Venezuela. And Salvador Perez, he of course is injured and out. Only 2 have been hit by Mexico. Timeout asked for that is a no pitch. When Walcott granted the timeout to the hitter who was hanging up there in that frozen position a little too long. As he
all right, man.
Minutes. He is with his team. Very sorry that he was out of action, but he says it's only inflammation. And that he should be playing within 2 weeks to do this in Kansas City. Alex Verdugo goes after it, fouls it away. Perez did have x-rays and an examination today and said no structural damage, so that is really great news for him. And he has stayed to cheer his team on, so inflammation in that left leg. Now, K-Rod is out. He's got a leg injury as he was injured on that very same play. So he is not available. And a reliever, Silvino Bronco,
He went out with a hamstring injury earlier in that game. So there are three players on the Team Venezuela that are not available to them. He went down to the cutoff man. Great play, but eventually had to come out of that game too. Jesus Flores has been added to the roster. He was the bullpen catcher for the first two games. Oh, what a nice little swing that was. The pitch down in the way, so he just took it to center field. And Verdugo is now 4 for 10, and more importantly for Mexico.
Verdugo, is that the Dodger guy?
Serve it up, missed by the middle. Ichiro Suzuki here by Alex Verdugo, and taking that pitch of
yep.
So he got thrown away. Just placing it. Mexico needs the cable center to provide anything they can for the people coming up here. So here's the first chance for Mexico to see if they can get on the board.
Pirate, not yet. We're doing eBay breaks right now.
2 for 5 and has a home run. He has got power. Look at the size that he brings to the plate. Due to the size is the power that he generates. Impressive power from this thriving Mexican veteran.
You don't have to be born in this country you're playing for. Or half the teams wouldn't have any players.
Jesse Davidor, 30 years old, native of Mexico in his first World Baseball Classic. Played in
Japan. Not in the eBay breaks. Not no Pixel. We will in the hit raft tonight, though.
He went for one down and away.
Napoli.
Away and they are dropping like we haven't seen here before. This is the first night where you feel as though the pitchers can actually get a grip on those breaking ball off speed pitchers. It's been so dry, so warm with the wind blowing in the previous games that pitchers are
now. This is all eBay stuff right here.
And hope for some sink. Two strike count, runners.
I'm going to the bathroom, guys. I'm probably going to break after this box.
Laird, the lead runner at second base.
For the Phillies, Jared Eichhoff. Nice, cool pinstripe. Makes me want candy.
Reaching, somehow got it. He hadn't had a long reach. There's no way he's going to get a piece of that one. Well, you mentioned that because if we look at where Amador stands,
I think you just have to have an ancestor born there within a certain generation of your life or whatever. I never remember. Asquies test for the Texans. Beltre out. 49.
You can see he's pretty much straight up. Look how much he's got room to work with on the other hand. 0-2 delivery on the way, and that ball down the line. That's going to be trouble. And we'll take a hop and hit off the base of the wall and bound away. Laird has scored. Verdugo
Mike Mussina, Masters of the Game out of 99.
Mexico has the one
Yankees
lead out of the RBI. And of course, why not use that reach when the pitch is elevated and just allow the ball to dictate what you will do? A proven hitter.
Press proof. Abreu out of 515. Woggio. See, I think Mussina is a Yankee. Boston, Benintendi.
Already, second inning on his way out to the mound after this two-bagger and an RBI with Laird crossing. And Edgar Gonzalez saying, thank you very much. We haven't seen this, and thank you, Alfred Amador. Take some of that load off the guys on the mound and for sure bring this crowd onto our side here. Gonzalez is not
Red Sox, Ryan.
In the first two games, they lost on a 5-run ninth inning by Italy against them in the first game, 10-9, and then Puerto Rico beat them by a score of 9-4. So his ball club's not been in the lead.
On a 99, high. Seattle, Cano.
Got the early lead here. Oh, those leadoff walks. So, two more in scoring position. Here is a big at-bat. Navarro. He's gone 3-for-6 with an RBI. Navarro will take it for a strike.
This is a given
be a good situational hitter. Use the middle of the field. And certainly, all you want to do is make contact here. But that run is yours to take.
We get a San Diego Dickerson.
He's trying to work his way around this. And taking a little too long getting set.
Are you watching?
Mexico
She's watching.
7 for 22 with runners in scoring position. And with that out-of-the-door hit, they're 1 for 1 in this one. 0-1 count. Runners off second at third base. Petit's delivery is going to come inside.
Oops. That was a mess up.
Petit's got a jam early on to deal with.
That was a mess up message. I didn't mean to send that.
BGO,
Houston.
Who does have a very good idea and a long track record in these types of situations. Navarro's got the outfield. Swung a little bit around towards left, opposite way on him. Pitch on the way. Petit got it up, but it's fouled off as he chopped it down the first baseline into foul territory. And a one ball, two strike count. Nice play, nice reach. Got great crowds here.
Man.
Particularly when
Bradley Zimmer for the Cleveland's.
Venezuela fans on hand. They're packed in here again tonight. And that parade for Puerto Rico again after the game was absolutely beautiful. As they had a 9-3 win over Italy in the first game today. Pitch tails away. That'll even the count up at 2 balls and 2 strikes on Efren Navarro. But what a chance for Mexico to have a big inning early in the ball game.
No Miami yet.
Navarro
well,
struck out only once in the first two games. Picked up
no, no ball. Miami. Well, here's a Miami out of 99, Christian Yelich.
Well, they're working up 28 pitches so far, and this is one inning plus. So Mexico with a plan that they've implemented after only 10 pitches by Petit in the first inning. Leadoff walk, some good advance for Dugo, Amador, now Navarro himself working a deep count. Cruz waiting on deck.
Out of 25 with the ding corner. Black, the Elite Series, Washington.
Runners on base. Gotta stay back here. Yep. 2-2 delivery on the way to check swing and a bouncer. Came right up.
I missed snow, man. It was like
no chance for the ball to get by.
Warm winter.
But a very solid defender, Robinson Chirinos, who in fact Salvador Perez mentioned today in an interview saying, hey, we have somebody that's called a lot of games in ballparks that are challenging. Of course, he's talking about Arlington.
Hakuna Matata.
First base open. Pitch on the way to him, and it's not open anymore. So Petit in trouble.
Out of 25, Kyle Wright.
That is the second walk he has surrendered in the inning. The first one to Lair as they run the cross. Now the sack's full. And Cruz going to the plate. As Gary mentioned, Venezuela's ERA coming into today, 9.72. And run prevention is...
All right, let me go to the bathroom real quick.
...under these conditions at this stadium right now. So Mexico gets one of the better chances they have had in the first three games for a big inning. Cruz has gone 1-for-6, has picked up a couple of RBIs, but not been able to strike him out. Petit's delivery is outside for a ball. Scary moment. Last time we saw Luis Cruz Gachito in the batter's box when he was struck by a mid-90s fastball coming out of the hand of Edwin Diaz from Puerto Rico, and the ball impacted his right index finger against the bat handle. But here he is. He's dead in the game then. Got it all taped up, Gary.
Yep.
And he goes, I am not missing this game for anything. Chirinos goes out to try and settle down his starter. Petit, minor league deal with the Angels in February. Last year with Washington, 36 games. Cruz on a 1-0 with the bases loaded. He will foul that one back. So Petit able to finally find that strike zone, and he'll go to 1-1. One of the things also happening, not only Mexico getting a chance to score, but Petit's being forced to throw a lot of pitches early on here after retiring the side in order in the first. with 22 pitches so far in this inning with nobody out. He is piling them up. One ball, one strikeout. Infield, a double play depth except at first. That one's going to be fouled back. He'll come down in front of home plate because it hit the overhang suspended roof here in this former track and field stadium. Unlike some ballparks, Tampa, I think of, the ball is not in play when it hits a portion of the suspended structure above the field. All those catwalks. Here you see it right there. Hit off that metal portion of that ring that goes all the way around. There we are in the loaded section up top. In the air, left field. That ball is deep. Will it stay in? Yes, on the warning track. Verdugo will tag it. He will score.
Damn.
Cruz will pick up the RBI. And it is a 2-0 lead, but I'm telling you.
Easy. Tell Gigi how fun it was submitting that big order of Gigi's. Was it very easy? I told him. Three times?
First out of the inning, Amador remains at second. Navarro on at first base. Cruz picks up his third RBI in full play. And Jorge Correa stands in with two on and one down. Double play depth all the way around now in the infield. Still have a talk about Rico dropping that fly ball recently and turning in big inning for Rico last time.
What issue's that, Easy? The Beckett dropping all the submitted cards.
And Petit evens up the count at 1-1. Mexico gets the early 2-0 lead. And a leadoff walk, as we've seen so often, not just in this World Baseball Classic, but throughout the history of the game, providing a run early. 1-1 delivery on the way.
Oh, does it?
A little late on that one. And a 1-2 count. Bullpen action. Already we are seeing it. And Jose Alvarado is up in the pen. He continues to throw this many pitches that are not particularly effective. He may be out of there early.
Man, I'm hungry. Shoot.
Here's the 1-2 delivery on the way. Another one came in with inside movement on it at 85, stays at 1-2. And we'll fight it. But now, the team is trying to drain more on the upper part of the zone than he would like to. Where he knows he cannot live. Mexico,
man, whoever we got was not very nice on grading corners.
Cool play. Give themselves a chance. 1-2 delivery on the way. Breaking ball he waited on down the line, right field. It's going to stay in play. Runner tags, moves over to third. Oh, look at the big man go. He was charging money.
For the Angels.
Ball to Gonzalez. I kind of love that. So Amador moves up. Navarro stays at first base, and there are two down. What a place they used to be known for track and field. How about the big man making the impact?
Whoa, Jose! We pulled an Arcia auto last night, Easy.
First and third, two away. Top of the order.
Oh, Mike D's got him tonight.
D with the chance to get out of it here. Good two down, and the pitch at the knees for a strike. The type of swing that Kito's has is quite conducive to one that can make a quick adjustment. Hits the ball so
Piss
well.
Scotty. Out of 99 for the Redbirds.
A lot of authority from the line, the corner in left field. If he stays back,
I figure that's what you're gonna do.
He can drive it the other way. Solid.
Peyton, are you able to update the forum right now?
Go top of that one and fouls it off.
If so, Darren wants the Braves. So he's in chat with you if you're still watching.
Esteban Quiros, the 25-year-old out of Sonora, Mexico, with his first World Baseball Classic appearance. O-2 count on him. We'll see if Petit comes after it. Or tries to get him to go after a pitch, maybe not a strike. Quiros has had a couple of RBIs so far. And a chopper. It's going to go foul.
Do what?
A little dance on that dangerously in front of Cabrera. As Cabrera couldn't see the ball.
Yelich. On a 25. There you go, D. Darren.
He's as busy as
Darren B.
And making sure the focus kind of shifts here and there, because he says, if I stand one thing and watch the pitch and watch the pitcher, I lock up. So on the defensive side, Miguel Cabrera is always chatting. There he is, talking to the fans. Distracting the opponent, talking to the dugout. All fun. Yogi Berra of our era. Continual chatter. 0-2 count, two down. And that one just missed a little bit away. Pretty good pitch there. They had a one ball, two strike count from Petit. I don't think Miggy would be a very good DH. Oh, no way. Couldn't stand him. Not being out on the field, having people to talk to, would drive you crazy.
Rockies.
One ball, two strike count with two down, first and third. Amador off third base. 1-2 delivery on the way. Breaking ball again. Held off it.
Murph, black and white.
And a good stop made by Torinos that time to keep it from going by.
That was pitch number 34 this inning for Gusmedo Petit.
Cespedes, Mets, out of 199.
Like these starters to get four or five innings.
Cal Ripken, Masters of the Game, out of 149.
Yeah, time after time. Two balls, two strike delivery on the way. And another one that's going to be fouled off. Out ahead of it that time off the end of the bat. Kiddo's doing the battle here. And the two ball, two strike count. This is the leadoff batter. Really making it work. Kiddo says a couple of walks that he has picked up, and he has not struck out first couple of games that he's played in. Pitches per player appearance throughout this inning have been remarkable.
Montez, Oakland Montez.
He's kind of wandering around here, waiting for something to happen. Long at bat.
And you wasted all your money.
Fouls that one off into the seats. Let's send it over to the family section.
Gregory.
Hopefully nobody heard on that. Whenever anything happens over there in that section, the players all take a long look. In fact, some are coming out of the dugout to take a look. That did hit somebody, and that is where family members are. Down remains two balls and two strikes on Quiros. First and third, the runners, and that one under his feet. So another full count. Three balls, two strikes on the leadoff batter.
You done?
So the seventh batter in the inning for Mexico. You can see they're all looking over there. Sure.
All right.
I don't know who it was, one of their family members.
Do you have a way that I can get a hold of you so Cam doesn't always have to?
Yeah.
Oh, you took your phone number?
Ball, two strike count. Two down, the runner at first will be running. Petit's delivery on the way. Quiros puts it up.
So that way, because Tammy's going to be gone next week.
Going back, yeah. Gonzalez at the wall looking. Hey, goodbye! Home run! Quiros delivers a three RBI shot on a 3-2 pitch with two down. And it is 5-0 Mexico.
And I gotcha. If you can work tomorrow, just come on in. If you come in tomorrow, let me know your hours, and I'll write you a check to the channel.
To the delight of the so many fans that have been waiting for this tournament.
Oh, Okay, that works. I'll have her send me it. And I'll just write you a check tomorrow if you come on. Yeah. Cool, thanks.
He has had four hits, two of them have been home runs. And with that, he's got five RBIs in the Classic. What a blow. Five runs on three hits now for Mexico. And Petit unable to keep those runners on base. So they're cleared now with two away. And the pitch is away for a ball. Urias at the plate.
Omar Vizquel knows exactly what is at stake if Mexico wins and you have three teams at one and two.
That ball in the air to left center. Guerrero will move over and will put it away. So eight batters come to the plate for Mexico in the second inning. They have a big five-run inning. Amador double in an RBI. Cruz with a sack fly and the three-run homer by Quiroz.
For the Cubbies, I don't think I've ever pulled this auto before. Or am I familiar with the player? Candy Lenaro. Isn't there a player from the 80s with that name? Oh yeah, guys, there's 14 teams left in the Plates and Patches football. It's a half case. The Cowboys will be randomized to everyone who gets a spot. That's good. That's a good post there, Hitties. Thanks for giving me a heads up on that. I forgot about the Cowboys being randomized. So get there's a few cheap teams left. Buy them up. They're all pretty cheap, really. It's a half a case of the football product.
So let's do this, Luis Mendoza. How about you be efficient with the pitch spread and know that you can spread it out and give your team some innings. Spin the ball and repeat it. Don't set it up only because, as you know very well, with Team Venezuela, you cannot fall asleep. There are a ton of professional hitters with some power who can hurt you quickly. So be one pitch ahead. Means, hey, if I mess with this one, what is the next one going to be? Because it happens that way.
Sorry, guys. I had to modify something real quick.
Lead Mexico. And a strike taken, Gonzalez. 3-for-8 RBI so far in pool play. Carlos Gonzalez batting in the cleanup spot, followed by Martinez and Herrera. Gonzalez getting the start in right field. Shift put on against him here. Here's the 1-1 delivery to it. And the pitch taken up high. For those who hear it the first time, we'll apologize for repeating it, but so you know the continued importance of the game. Mexico wins this game. We get to look at potential tie-breaking rules. If Venezuela wins this game, they are the runner-up second seed to Puerto Rico coming out of this pool.
Who hosts out of 500?
The delivery is a good pitch that had sink on it. Now, it's interesting when they move on to this second round, where the Dominican Republican team, USA, are going to be. It's going to be winner against
nice.
Winner.
Nice. Man, there's a lot of low numbers in this USA.
Very first games played. So the Dominican Republic's going to play Puerto Rico in the games in San Diego. First game. And then the USA is going to play the...
Whoa, Xander! Oh, my God.
To be determined here tonight. So immediately right back to the championship.
The Jags are only 15 bucks, he's saying. Is that the deep, cheap team?
That one's going to be fouled off. We end up with the three teams being tied.
Close your eyes, hitties. Close your eyes.
That will eliminate one of them. And the two left will play tomorrow. We got a long way to go before we have to get into the details of that, but just keep that in mind. And at that time, please bear with us.
Yeah, Hitties, we will probably try to do a filler draft if next, well, after the football break.
Carlos Gonzalez. Yeah, a swing and a miss. Second strikeout picked up by Mendoza. Well, he just found it. That's what I'm talking about. You got to spin the ball, and you can get a different bunch because it has to be north, south, and little. He's left. Whatever works for you. Certainly that is only due to the might of his pitching coach, Rigo Beltran, and of course, Fernando Valenzuela, who is a pitching advisor to the dugout. The prayers have started early for the teams from Mexico. Never too early, never too late. Almost never enough. Mr. Martinez, the DH, has had a 1-for-5. And Martinez will take the pitch up, probably a little bit inside as well. One down, nobody on here in the bottom half of the second inning.
Rob? Okay. Are you able to post in the forums, Rob? If not, I'll let Peyton know. Since we're live, we can do the live. We got to get folks used to posting in the forums.
1-0 delivery. Martinez will take it for a strike. There you hear the drums, Fernando. El Toro. A true charro de Jalisco. Fernando Valenzuela. He joined quite a group of players in baseball history from Mexico prior to the game. They had a lineup out there of some 20-plus players.
Okay.
In history playing ball from
Mexico. She's going to get you added, but I just wanted to know if you have that ability.
Wanted to call on that one.
And if not, let me... try to help anyone who doesn't have any. There's a few folks that are having trouble with it. It's not difficult to run. I just don't know. I don't have any of the information on how to run it, Gigi. And I really haven't. I kind of like the forum, honestly. But. Thanks, Rob. He did pose there, Hitty.
He'll take a walk here if he can get it to get something started. I go back to that fastball. Everyone pitched anyway. Boy, that's what Mendoza didn't want to do. So he will give up the walk, and Victor Martinez will hit down the first base, the first base runner for Venezuela.
You know, this might be a case with Mendoza, who has outstanding two-seam fastball. May have to take it down and find out.
Oh, you're at it, Rob. Thank you, dear man. Hitties.
This is not a bad pitch at all.
Behind home plate. Hey, the same fastball, if I call it inside, let's throw it right at his front hip. It better run back over the plate. Here is Herrera. The double Herrera, who's 1-for-5. Mendoza's delivery to him. Came with straight heat right there and got it in there. Mendoza last year.
All right. Alex Bregman on a 99. Houston. Hey, this has been a good half taste.
That he appeared in. professional baseball in the United States.
Herrera waiting with a runner at first. Hitties, go ahead and take off the.
Drops the bat, gets out of the way. It was an interesting way to avoid
the eBay. Now that I think about it, of the pleats and patches, we'll be breaking that for sure tonight. We'll run a filler of some sort.
Sends back in with a one ball, one strike count. Well, he's put together. What happened is sparked for those killers. Venezuela's still looking to get their first hit. One ball, one strike count. Runner up first base. Martinez not being held. That'll go in the air to right field. Almost where he was positioned. Heroes puts it away.
Are we talking about separation enough, Gary?
Not separation from you, by the way. Although I don't blame you. There'd be no problem. But I'm talking about fastball separation and change up and all that.
So, last pitch is a great swing by Portobello Herrera. He thinks it's gone. I mean, Portobello, keep watching what the ball is not doing here tonight.
Before he flipped the bat like that.
But it was 80 miles an hour.
It's been 86, 88, got one down. And that's what I'm talking about, the separation that goes from a lot of those pitches. So two away, Martinez remains at first base. Here is Escobar. 2-for-8, 3 RBIs in this classic. And we'll take the pitcher of all. That bat right there by Herrera tells you how much the ball is not carrying here tonight.
I mean, he seriously thought he got it.
He seriously thought he got it. No one's getting close. I mean, that was just to a normal right field position. Escobar waiting on it. Foul territory, which there is a lot of here. Gonzalez running, reaching. Not quite.
Carson Fulmer.
Sowojos. Is enormous. Without knowing the exact measurements, probably more than any other ballpark. So, it's not going to be even bigger than Oakland. Oakland still has a lot of foul territory, but not as much as this.
Well, we can never question the effort. I mean, look at this, as Gary's referring to it. The many quarters that are involved also as you round and go and find your way in that foul territory where you actually go on a full sprint.
Kershaw, 99.
Corner infielders having a full sprint after a foul ball very often, but you do here. They really have to go. And the outfielders have no chance to get in. Where that ball landed there, nobody's going to get there from the outfield. One ball, one strike delivery on the way. That one's going to go to center field. And Verdugo is there to put it away. No runs, no hits, no errors. And one left on base. Two complete in a must-win game for Mexico.
Thank you, Peyton. Mookie Betts, Dominator. Washington Severino. .500 Stanton for the Miamis. Jose De Leon out of 199, the rookies for the Dodgers. Travis and Gina. And how about some more Jose De Leon out of 199? Ink this time. Manny Machado out of 999. And 181 for St. Louis, Matt Carpenter. Out of 99, Rick Porcello. Yeah, any auto is better than no auto. He's not a Dodger anymore, is he? Is he a Brave? No, Ray? I can't remember. I always get Braves and Rays mixed up. So. Jenkins? Yeah, I don't know. Hyflu, I'd like to do something with bracket. Gosh, I ain't even done anything myself with the bracket. No chickens, man. No chickens. I did last year an optic out of 15. I'm trying to sell that thing. Nobody ever buys it. Took the Jags too, Rob. Hear that, Peyton? Rob just took the Jags as well. Payment sent. Thanks, Rob. Get the teams, guys. All the teams you get, the more chance you have at getting the... GG took the Broncos. Getting the Cowboys.
He'll be followed by Laird and Verdugo here in the third inning for Mexico. 2-0 delivery. And that one's found right straight back. Carry that hole in between. I'm in between. The one thing is hitter. I'm a little bit too early. I'm a little bit too late.
Yeah. Now, what were you? What Chris Bryant did you text me about, Darren? I wasn't sure what you meant about buy it now. What did I list for you? I didn't list a Bryant. Did I listed the? Harper. I was hoping I didn't list the wrong one. No, I didn't pull it, Brian. Land the intro. What up, Card Collector 89?
Want that sombrero? Yeah, I'm coming. Uh-oh, I'm gonna get that sombrero. That's the best one I've seen. Good buddy, that's beautiful. Two balls, two strikeouts.
Oh, Snoop Dogg. How about a Mike Trout? Flipped right into my hand.
Great get-ups.
11 left.
So Ledesma works the count to three balls and two strikes on the number three hitter, Gonzalez. He can go out there spread out now. And stride as little as possible.
Anthony Rizzo printing plate for the Cubbies.
Big packed house here on this Sunday night. Full count delivery. And that's outside, not close.
Harper, can you add a buy it now price also to go with?
Laird got one in the second inning and would score.
Oh, gotcha.
For Mexico who did not come up in the second.
I don't know. Did you already list it, Peyton? Is a whammy?
You're able to track the pitch better. Anything to get on, get things started. That's what it's all about. Laird with the 2-for-9. We'll stand back in. Now, Venezuela is trying to find their footing in this game. They are going to have an active...
Who has the Cubbies?
Going only
Nick. Whoever Nick is.
And that's going to be taken down low for a ball by Laird.
I don't know. You might be able to revise it. If there's no bids, you probably can. You out of here, man? Just step on him. It won't hurt him. Thanks, man.
Time
base,
change.
Yeah, man. Get home to sleep. I don't want to wear you out.
Actually,
one open pitch on the way.
Now I want traps.
Altuve. And a double play.
I know, I'm hungry now. All right, man. Tomorrow, when you come in, I'll get you checked.
6-4-3 on that one, so that eliminates that leadoff walk, and there are two down. Automatic.
Yeah, nobody came in this weekend.
Two up the middle.
Oh, well, Friday, yeah. I mean, yesterday nobody did. But that's all right, man. I'll see if I can recruit somebody. Mickey. Coop.
Word got around before you know it. We're taking infield, outfield, and the whole team shows up at their own minicamp, all voluntary.
Man, we pulled us.
And he picked up a single and scored in the.
Yeah, there will be a hit draft. It'll be another hour. I got to get through another box of this. I'm gonna try to go fast, man. I'm just getting burnt out on these big base picks. Shoot. Thanks, man.
There's the mask you were talking about. Let's go on, Eagle. Great. That's the one you want right there. Yes, that's what I want. Thank you, sir. I do appreciate that. Oh, boy. Hey, mask. There you go. Mask wins. He loses.
Kendall or DZ. At least you got something on number 200 or less.
We have to wait again for another WBC. That's the hard part. It's once every 4 years. One ball, one strike, and two away. Over the top, pitch will be taken inside, and the count goes to 2-1.
I'm the same way. I'm not a.
Another game.
I'm tired of the.
A tiebreaker.
NCAA. Basketball.
Right back.
I might watch it. Glenn Otto. We already had a. What? That's the second Otto out of 25, isn't it?
1-2. If Mexico wins.
That's a goodbye for them. Oh oh.
Big cut and an uppercut fouled it off the leg foot and.
Reyes out of nothing but an auto for the St. Louis. That's nice.
Great job by Gonzalez getting on. Clear control play, but you cannot be complacent or sit on that 5-run lead because that could quickly just dissolve.
No, we're doing optic football next.
Ballpark or not? I think it's Venezuela. That line they have. No, we saw
Murray.
Stage on that one with a 5-run ninth inning.
Your third, I think this is the third black and white MVP you've got there, Mike. George Brett.
Double A ball, 273 last year. 13 homers, 63 RBIs. He was the 2015 Dodger Minor League Player of the Year. That was his first
Kluber
as a pro. And Adrian Gonzalez really likes this young Dodger barman. He's only 20.
I thought you were meant tonight. Esquies test. White Sox, Chris Sale.
Tag is put on. So Ledesma picks up a strikeout, faces only three despite a leadoff walk. We'll go to the bottom of the third, 8-9-1 coming up for Venezuela.
Verlander, Tigers, Benintendi. Yeah. More Dodgers? Yes, we are breaking that tonight, Darren. Oh my gosh. Tells you how tired I'm getting. I slept good today. Didn't get a lot of shipping done, but I slept good. This whole time change just blew me out, man. We had a, what did we hit? We hit a George Brett out of 10 tonight. Card collector, which was sweet. Benintendi out, yeah. I'm not rooting for him. I'm rooting for him to lose it so he has extra money to spend with me.
We don't mean those are the only ones who'll be there, but Gaskell and that group, you would believe, are going to get some serious consideration for the Hall of Fame on the 2018 ballot. We still talk about it first day here. One of the first questions asked by the Mexican media about the Hall of Fame chance is Joe Pagani. Billy Humphrey, know that my numbers are there. I know exactly what other shortstops have done, and I'm feeling very confident that because of longevity and production throughout the longevity, I have a pretty good chance. I think he's going to make it.
I agree. Yeah.
Pitch is taken down low, and down goes to 2-0. Man, with so many gold gloves, especially at an advanced age, he was out playing some of the younger guys at shortstop. That is quite a group, though, the force that we showed you. They are all serious contenders. Pitch is taken inside, and they're in Ciate, his first bat in the ballgame, 1-for-7. Here in the Classic, there is Omar, as good a glove player as you would hope to find. And a serious competitor. He came a hitter in the big leagues. He's taking all the way. That is going to be in there for a strike. I remember talking with him towards the end last year, in fact, that he played. And I said, Omar, what do you want to do? And he said, I'm going to manage. He's, as you were saying, he's not one of those guys who hesitates or works around the bush and stuff. No. He'll tell you whether, you know, that's what I think, that's what I'd like. If I get there, fine. If I don't, fine. But I want to manage. He's, by forcing the first bit of the Tigers, but I got to believe this day will come somewhere else with the Tigers or someone else as a manager. With other respect of the group of mega superstars, you know, the standard respect of that speaks loudly. Especially with a Latin American former player. Ciate goes after. That's going to be up the middle. He's got a tough play. Running throw. Oh, mercy. What an arm on that guy. That's a running throw heading into left field. That is like way too easy. Suave is who he's through. A little bit of an issue at shortstop first game, but second base looked to his right. He knew exactly where to start that throw. So with the tail action of it, it was fine.
I don't know yet, Casey. We rarely have non-payers.
It's right on the money. They call that a Robinson Cano play because I'm not sure I've seen
it. A lot of times,
throws like that where you're going in the left field.
I don't know until after the break.
And he just flips. And the ball
or they cancel.
Right into the glove, just as Cruz did right there. That's a rough play. Right, taking one down here in the third inning. Talked to a couple first basemen that played next to Cano, and they said there's times when we think he's not going to throw it before you know it. It's coming right out of the chest. Yeah.
We do have the football break that's getting close, Casey. I don't know if you're in that. The plates and patches. That'll be breaking tonight.
And the pitch taken down low. Mexico on top here by a score of 5-0. We're in the bottom half of the third inning. Robinson Chirinos doing the catching.
Adrian Gonzalez on a 199. Todd Frazier on a 999. I'm trying to fly here. Tanaka out of 445. Rookie of the year. Seager.
I have a chance to see him every day with the Baltimore Orioles. That's Jonathan Schoop. He's a young second baseman who's got a tremendous arm. And he is just developing into the everyday major league player. Boy, I think you're going to see plays like that out of him.
Oh, man, I thought you were going to get an Abreu. Nope, just out of 199.
That one is going to be bounced, and the count will go to 3-1 in the meeting.
You're the one, my friend, that told me one day in Baltimore, Jose.
Just stand behind the cage and watch Jonathan.
Jay Bruce. Oh, dirty bat.
Machado's. And at that time, Nelson Cruz, you were absolutely right. Yeah, and it's loud, very loud. And I think it's a perfect place for a young player because he doesn't have to do a lot of things in order to make the team go. You've got Manny Machado, you got Adam Jones, you got Chris Davis, you got Trumbo. I mean, you've got all kinds of great, really good players around you. So as a young player, you can learn and develop. The guy you see the most is going to be to your right, J.J. Hardy. Yeah. Draws the walk. That'll be the second surrender. Ryan Mendoza in the game. So Gary, one away, runner on, top of the order, Altuve coming up.
Gary,
and they have Buck. And they have Buck Showalter, who helps develop players by keeping some guys under the radar when it's better for them. And teaching them how to get it done. And J.J. Hardy, I'll end the story. J.J. Hardy is a coach on the field, the shortstop of the Orioles.
Chad Pinder, Oakland.
He listens, and J.J. talks. And it's a tremendous combination, tremendous learning experience.
Next week we're doing four boxes because eight is insane. I don't know what I was thinking, man. I wasn't. That's the problem.
24 home runs with his 5-5 second baseman out of Maracay in Venezuela. 224 hits, 2014. He set the single season record for a Venezuelan-born player. Obviously, one of the great numbers of all time when it comes to what he gets up on a board. He can do it. Look at those. Wow. Single season hit leaders by Venezuelan born players. Altuve, two seasons where he's been at the top. One ball, one strike delivery on the way. That's going to be amazing.
Chris Bryant on a 999.
Trinos will make a turn and stay as Verdugo will get it in. So there's
Bryce Harper out of 999.
If you're going to pick somebody in the lineup to get it, Altuve would have been the one. And he does.
You're right. 225 season in 2014, followed by a 200-hit season in 2015. And then the last one was 260.
Malik Smith for the Braves.
The big leagues today. You would not expect to see that time after time from a guy who was 5-5.
He can do it. And so can Prado. Prado struck out his first time up, 5-for-9 now in the series. One down, two on. Infield will look
The football optic, Deason. The one I believe you're in.
First time he's had a runner down there.
I think you're in.
And the pitch is there for a strike.
Robin Yount.
A great man to have in the batter's box right now. Look the way he's been swinging the bat. Shortstop, Reyes moves it behind the runner. Little roller, that's one off the foot. Ouch.
Three times tonight.
Wow, he's really limping on this one. Court, but those are going under.
Cool.
He's taking bigger swings today. Watch how big a swing he's got today. Little pull up. That's why he's getting more in the top half of the baseball than you saw yesterday when he was squaring the ball off. He's a little upset. It's three times tonight. Got the guard on there, but it doesn't make it feel a whole lot better.
All right.
Martin Prado. Rios down at second base. Altuve on at first. Outfield deep, swing around to right. Big gap in left center field. Is that protector? And that's where he goes. Base hit. And making the turn at third base. Rios is going to be sent home. Runner's going to go to third, and a run is in. RBI for Prado.
All right, so Wojo with the Carson Fulmer auto in the grade box, Wojo.
A great play by the second baseman Cruz has at least stopped one runner.
Robin Young, Malik Smith, Pinder, Bruce, White Sox, Dodgers, White Cubbies, White Sox, Oreos, St. Louis, non-team, Tampa Bay, Cleveland, Cubbies, Trouty, Red Sox, Dodgers, Dodgers, Washington. It sucks, man. What was that noise? I heard a ding.
Takes the cut, it'll go to short. Reyes is there. Cruz, one. Relay over the first. And they turn the double play, and that is a big one. A run in on a couple of hits, no errors. One left on base. The double play will end it, though. Cabrera hits into it. The RBI picked up by Prado has put Venezuela on the board. And if a double play was ever needed, Mexico needed that one and they got it.
I'm select. Well, did you send for the Twins yet, Keeson? I mean, how did we want to do that, by the way? Blue Jays, Astros, Red Sox, USA, Reds, Chicago Cubs, Oakland A's, Orioles, Rocky Owls, Miami Owls, St. Louis, Milwaukee, Okay, good. USA, Washington, Miami, Cleveland, Seattle, Boston, oh, Yankees, oh, see, I almost said Orioles, Texas, Philly, Cleveland, Boston, Minnesota, San Diego, Diego, Astros, Birdie not, Texas, Washington, San Franskin, Kansas City, Toronto, Texas, Orioles, Phillies, Dodgers, Detroit, Kansas City, Treat, White Sox, Cubby Sox, Beltre, Texas, Mets, Indians, Twins, Rockies, look at that Rocky patch, that's pretty cool. Toronto, Seattle, USA, and Pittsburgh. Football time! Sorry for the delays, guys. The hour threw us off, and that break is a big one.